Hello everyone, and welcome to episode 10 of my Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. mock build series. As you can see in this video, the outro and intro are in my Lego workspace where I work on my mock, and not in my room where I usually do the intros and outros. I just wanted to change a little bit, and also I do hope you guys like that brand new intro by Zach FB Studios on Instagram, and I'll link his YouTube channel down in the description below. But Zach, if you're watching this, thank you so much. The intro looks amazing, and it's just turned out way better than I thought. I do want to say that episode 9 of this building series was very well received. I got a lot of comments, subscribers from that video, and likes, which really means a lot. Like, I remember last week before that, I had like maybe 33, 34 subscribers. Now I have 40, and it really means a lot. I do want to say, those of you, the majority of you guys who watch my videos are not subscribed, so I recommend you guys go ahead and subscribe. You get the alerts of when the next episode of this series is out, and also other videos on my channel. And so in this episode, we continue to build upwards. Give you guys a sneak peek. So let's go ahead and get on with this episode. Hey everyone, so starting this week's episode, as you can see, here's the row of inverted slopes. Don't worry, they will be black. I did get more black inverted slopes to replace the gray slopes that you see. But this row is basically to prevent the ramp that will be closing off the opening to the cargo over there from being too long. And so, just give you a few more angles. But I actually did get more parts right over there, and I'm gonna be reviewing them right now. So here are the parts that I got for this week's episode, starting off with this little pipe piece. So this I actually didn't buy. I found it in one of my Lego buckets, but it's very stretchable. Like, I can bend it like this, and it's gonna be very useful for the railing part at the second level. Here are some tubes, or pipes, whatever you want to call them, red and black ones that will be used for the upper section of the cargo. And I really like these pieces. Here are some one-by-one bricks with knobs on one side. These are going to be helpful with connecting the pipes for the upper part of the cargo area. Here we got some 1x4 black bricks to help with the edges of the plane if I didn't finish that off. We have some 2x2 inverted black slopes that will help decrease the length of the ramp, which I'll explain later on in this episode. We got 72 light bluish gray cheese slopes. These will help replace the green cheese slopes. We got these claw pieces, I don't even know what you call them, light and dark bluish gray, to help with the railing and also with the upper section of the cargo area. We have 1x1 black bricks to also help with the edges of the plane. We have 1x3 black bricks to help with the edges of the plane. We have 1x2 bricks as well. And we have like these clip pieces that will help with the railing of the second level. So here are all the parts that I collected for this episode. I'm gonna go ahead and sort, and I'll show you guys what I do with these pieces. Hey everyone, so this is what the mock is looking like so far. As you can see, here are some filler brick to keep the edges from falling over because they're very unsturdy before, but now they're pretty sturdy. Here's the back of the row. So I'm just gonna sort these parts. I'm probably gonna do a time lapse of me replacing the green cheese slopes with the light bluish gray ones, and building the edges upwards more. Without further delay, let's see what I do. So that time lapse was me basically sloping all of this part upwards. You might have seen my head or some things break, but luckily I was able to make everything sturdy. On the other side is basically a whole lot of filler as well, as you can see right there. So that's good. So that part's pretty sturdy. So now all I have to do is create like that black outline going all the way down over there, just like I did for this side. I should have enough black parts to do that. But first thing I'm going to do actually is I'm going to see if I have enough inverted slopes and black to make this whole row, column, whatever you want to call it, all black. So I'm going to go ahead and actually do another time lapse of me replacing the gray with black. As you can see, I was unable to finish covering it all with black inverted slopes. I still have a few more light bluish gray slopes that I need to replace with black. So I'll try to find them or order them if I can't find them, but I think I'll be able to find them somewhere in one of my Lego buckets. But I don't think this camera does it justice. Like, not only is it somewhat long, but it's just really, really big. I'm very happy with the way this turned out. I've been working on this mock for over a year. We're in the home stretch now. Like they say, we're in the end game now. Haha, get it? Okay. But there's just a lot of filler getting the end slopes sturdy on both sides. It's coming along real nice. So right now I'm going to change the green cheese slopes that you see with the light bluish gray that I got on both sides. Unfortunately, I forgot to order the translucent clear 1x4 tile pieces to replace the white. But I'll try to get that for a future episode. It's not that important right now. I can just swap it anytime. So I'm sure some of you guys will ask me, isn't like the end part supposed to be longer? It is. So what I have in plan is actually I'm designing the wings currently on LDD. And what's going to happen is, so the wings are going to start here, or like the top, which will include the wings, are going to start here. And it's going to extend outward. So a little bit more from right here is going to extend outward to get the curvature and the slopes right. But this right here was just to prevent the ramp from being really long. But overall, I think it'll look nice at the end. The wings, when I'm done, that'll be a separate episode. Let's replace those cheese slopes and see what else I can build upwards. Hey everyone, so this is basically all the progress I was able to do in like about 2 to 3 hours worth of work. So I was able to replace the green cheese slopes with the light bluish gray ones, and it's the same on the other side, but the other side doesn't have this part up, but it has like everything else from right here all the way down there, except for the upper part. But it's looking really, really good. So here's the reference picture that I've been using, which I showed in the last episode. So I'm trying to adjust the camera, but so basically that red tube you saw was supposed to represent this. And basically I just got a lot of pipe/tube pieces to go over the dark bluish gray area. And so that was what I was trying to replicate over here, and I think I did a very good job. Don't worry, I will try to get dark bluish gray inverted slopes, so that will replace the black slope and then the light gray slopes that you see. Basically, I just wanted to have like something in its place rather than leave it empty. But this is like the design I was going for, so I'm very lucky that I have two or four of these red pipe two pieces, whatever you want to call them. So basically I'm going to have another one here. It'll go all the way down like that, and it'll be the same on the other side. And as you can see, I did the railing, actually. It wasn't that complicated of a design. I knew when I ordered the parts exactly what I was going to do. I was basically going to take one of these pieces and place it on top of one of these. And then boom, and then get the, I actually found two of these flexible tubing pieces, and it'll just go like that. So that's what I was able to do over there. I think it looks very, very good. I'm really happy with the way it turned out to be. As you can see, you got the agent guy, but it's looking very, very nice. Gonna try to get more angles. Unfortunately, there's like a bunch of Lego and other miscellaneous things here that I need to clear, but I'll try to get that angle. I don't think you can kind of see. Maybe, maybe not. That part right there, kind of see the railing. Next episode, I'll try to clear all these parts or other like Lego, whatever. So that way you'll get a better view of right over there. So yeah, so this is what I was able to do. Again, here, I'll show you guys the other side. I don't have the upper part, but you can kind of see. So the white tiles will be replaced with clear ones, so don't worry about that. But again, I just really love the railing. I think I did a really good job on the railing part. Unfortunately, when I move the slopes, or when the slopes get higher up, it will like cover like from this angle right here when I place the camera facing that way, right over here. The slopes will kind of block like the upper half of like this part, which is fine though. I mean, if you go down low enough right here in this opening, if the camera is like right here, you can be able to see it. But yeah, really liking the progress that I made. This is gonna wrap up this week's episode. I'll see you guys in the outro. So this is gonna conclude episode 10 of my Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. mock build series. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Again, I continue to make progress every week. I do wanna say, I hope you guys are well, safe and healthy. I know this is strange times due to the coronavirus as I'm recording this video. So that means I'm quarantined at home, which gives me a lot of time to work on the mock. Thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe, leave a like, comment down below, and I'll see y'all soon.